Evening all, welcome to this commentary edition. Well, you know, I'd spent ages doing this video and yet, you know, I thought, well, I might as well get the mileage out of it. So I thought I'd do another track. This is the second audio track for it. And this is me talking about this video. So anyway, let's talk about it. This is obviously last year's video. I love doing these things because this is kind of what I do. This is what I do after Christmas when I've sobered up a bit, is I sit and just go through the year's footage of what we've done with Dust and then basically cobble together something like this. So we're going to talk about it. Woo! I think we're going to try and talk about it coherently. So let's begin. Well, this is a great start to the year. Tanks were just being spammed, weren't they? It was ridiculous, that was. That was actually a court mate of mine. He was on the other team and he learnt the hard way not to mess with us. We also orbital tanks back then. This is when life was good. To be honest, it was an interesting time because I don't know if you remember, Dust 514 at this point was before the whole fanfare stuff. So it was very popular and it was also a very aggressive place. People were jostling and jockeying for relevance and position, I would probably say, which is good because there was actually a real kind of, I don't know, that was a great feeling to the game. And I think it's a shame almost that the thing's kind of disappearing a bit, because I think nowadays it does feel that there's less aggression, maybe. Moving on, we had this kind of idea of Masters of the Universe. This was just a massive troll to annoy people, and it worked quite well because you're not really good at this game if you're only really good at a combat rifle or a shotgun. You're good at this game if you're good at everything, like, you know, dropships, tanks, scout suits, heavy suits, forge guns, whatever it may be. If you're, you know, you're really good at it, that's one of the things to do. This also was a hilarious thing. For some reason, matchmaking never really works, does it? We had one red and a whole team of 16 people against him. So we decided that our little gang would be his bodyguard. Now, he didn't know about this. So we're trying to defend a guy and he doesn't know that we're on his side. So he's shooting us and hunting us. It is hilarious. I've never had so much fun in the game. They should do that. They should make a mode where it's just literally one guy on one team versus six, and it could be like a hunter killer sort of thing. That'd be pretty cool, wouldn't it? But again, you know, what's the point in saying that? I honestly don't know where they're going with this game. Even I think this war barge, this is from PS Home, I think they're discontinuing that soon as well. That is actually going to disappear, or maybe has already disappeared, I don't know. So I think it's not looking good for Dust in the future. I could be wrong, but I don't think they're going to pull the plug, don't get me wrong. I think actually they've got a great little IP here, but I think they're probably going to mess with it and turn it into something else, which could be good, it could be bad, who knows. I'm still a big fan of the game, I still love it. I mean, look at it, we do all these videos for it still. It's not the most kind of grossing videos on YouTube, I must admit. If, you know, there's not many of us doing videos for this game, but sadly enough, it's because it's quite a difficult game to get something from. If you play, I mean, DayZ is probably a good example. If you play DayZ, you're going to have like two or three really incredible encounters and fights and tense moments. This is more like Counter-Strike, where it's a constant to and fro. Anyway, there was a Million Clone event. Don't know if you remember that. That was actually really cool. I missed it almost entirely. Oh no, sorry, I lied. There was two in the year, wasn't there? The first one I did do, and I actually got the stretch as well. But the second one I didn't do. Or did I? Maybe I just did just enough, like 60 matches or something like that, just enough, and I got all the bonus as well, so I was quite happy about that. So thanks for carrying me, dude. Almost incredible to think that March was where the scout suit began. I don't remember that. I really don't. I thought I've been running scout a lot longer than that, but maybe not. 1.8 came. I did my little skit on the Predator here. This took forever. I actually did a version where you had the heat map as well. But, you know, I did like 3 frames of it and it took me an hour. So I thought, well, I'd have to do another 190 frames or something stupid like that. So I thought, yeah, no offense, bugger this. But I kind of did the idea of the Predator game, Aliens vs. Predator game, where he's got different filters for different creatures. I quite like that. But cloaking, wow, what an addition. I did hear on the grapevine that that was actually done quite quickly by a very few number of people. So I think it does show the qualities of CCP in a kind of, you know, Gondor-y way. They certainly seem to have, as I say, qualities. I think they're good. I think some of the stuff they've done is excellent. So, you know, it does show that they're able to introduce new stuff. And I imagine being a games developer is all about doing new stuff. So yeah, let's hope they're keen and interested in this, but you know, I don't know. I imagine Legion is taking a lot of the team's time. At least I hope it is. Well, You know, I guess I do, but I just, you know, part of me really hopes that Legion is coming, and it's coming soon. Because I don't know, there's, let me tell you why there's a barrier for me now. There is a barrier for me to switch my PS3 on. There is. Because my PC's on all the time. Literally, as soon as I wake up, it's on. I know people who don't even switch their PC off. They've left their PC on for like 3 years, literally. It's just on permanently. But for me, my computer is always on because I'm always doing stuff, I'm always surfing the web, you know, I'm always doing videos, whatever. But the PlayStation has to be switched on for this to work, for, you know, to play Dust. And there is a barrier still in doing that. I don't know why, it's just because sometimes, I don't know, you feel like you got a lot of technology on and it just drives me a bit mad. And I think, you know, the PS3 as well, God almighty, that whole PSN stuff at Christmas was quite damning when you think about it. I mean, whole kind of days and days, even weeks, where you can't log on. I did do a live stream just before Christmas, and it was shockingly bad to get a game. I couldn't even get in the game. The gangs kept messing up. It was evident something was massively wrong, like cripplingly wrong with the whole thing. But none of it was CCP. It was all apparently PS Home. And it's because somebody was hacking it. And, you know, and I don't know the where's and the why's and the how's and the where to's to of why people hack. Is up to them. It's mainly because I don't want to be hacked, so I'm never going to be critical of it, because I think, you know, sometimes people are making a statement. The statement I think this group were making, that you should be more about family and home rather than sitting on Call of Duty all through Christmas Day. And, you know, I kind of hear that. I kind of do get that. But having said that, you can't kind of put yourself in a position of power and deny content to people. You can't just say, well, I'm cleverer than you, or I'm better than you. You're not allowed to play this. That's kind of wrong and illegal. But there we go. Right, on to the fanfest. We never did talk about this much, but we were contacted by Monsieur Rouge and Monsieur Saberwing well in advance of fanfest, and we had I don't know if I'm not supposed to say that or not. Sorry if I've just broken the NDA. I promise I didn't mean to. But what we did is we were asked if we could do a little video for FanFest, and we were honoured, deeply honoured. So Trouble and I sat down and we penned the mightiness of this video you see here, which was, and the single concept of this video was, I wanted to put the word bollocks in FanFest on the screen in, you know, 50 foot high letters or whatever, however high the screen is. I just wanted the word bollocks to be broadcast to everybody. So you can see their bollocks. That was the compromise, because I was told by some of their, quote, marketing and PR team, you can't just have the word bollocks without context. So I was like, okay, well, let's, you know, there was an email exchange on the context of bollocks. So, you know, could I use bollocks with this word, or could I maybe use bollocks with that word? And the whole email chain was the most surreal discussion I've ever had in my life ever. However, we decided that we would go with the words bollocks to serious business, not knowing that Hilmar would start his keynotes, kick off the Dust, the FanFest with Eve is now becoming serious business. And it's like, oh shit, okay, this isn't going to work. So we were kind of aware that this was coming. Anyway, so we kept it a secret. Matt, somehow we managed to keep this all a secret. And we did this video, just cobbling together footage from quite a long time ago, to be honest. But the idea was, is they wanted something that celebrated the game. And I'd like to think we did that. I think we pulled together something quite corny and ironic and funny. We put a little bit of Eve footage in just to kind of keep the Eve pilots in the crowd interested, if there were any. But we, you know, we were deeply honored to do this. So thank you, CCP, for letting us do this. This was fun. We enjoyed it. And I think, you know, these kind of videos are a challenge. And it's kind of like anything, really. You can do a YouTube channel where you play a game, you talk over it, and you upload it. That's only really half of it. The bit that is the quality side of it is how coherent it is, how exciting it is, how enjoyable it is. And that's where we really pushed the boat out, because we love doing these videos where we can do that. Oh my God, the Dust Battles series. We've got packs of these things if you want them. We just got sent, what it was is we got them printed and we gave two boxes away to Rouge and Saberwing because they're our bros. And we then printed two or three more packs for ourselves just so we could film with. But the printers buggered the order up, and they actually, they put a slight imperfection in the card. You can't even see it. But Trouble spotted it and said, oi, you know, we're not happy with this. So they just reprinted the whole lot again. So we've got packs and packs of these cards. So we may do a competition or something. I'm not sure yet. We can't sell them because we don't have the rights to do that. But maybe if we give them away, I don't know, that might be a bit of fun. But, you know, it was an interesting kind of thing because we did that in tribute to Dust, not knowing that obviously the news that was going to be announced was going to be announced. And I think that was, it was quite, well, it wasn't shocking for the obvious reasons, I think you can guess. But I think really, we didn't maybe anticipate how much people would react badly to it. I guess I kind of thought it was, because I remember saying to Saberwing, look, you're probably going to get a little bit of grief, you know, about this and blah, 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 blah. And just because of the way that kind of it was going, can't really say too much more than that, but there definitely seemed to be something, what's the word I'm looking for? I'm trying not to break the NDA. let me try and put it this way. I think it was evident that there was going to be a poop storm and the poop storm happened. But I think maybe it kind of happened in a different way or a different part of the country, for example. Because I think people maybe, I think there was an expectation that people would be happy. Because when obviously they announced it's coming to PC, a large group of people probably would be quite happy about that. And a large group of people are not going to be happy about that. And I think even, you know, I couldn't have called that myself. So there we go. On to like the further few bits. I mean, I've got to admit, after FanFest, it was a pretty desolate time. I don't know if you played after FanFest. I remember people who had played maniacally for years, ever since the game was released, just stopped. And that was a surprise. I couldn't quite work out why that was. Anyway, so onto the thing. This was a real big kind of, this was a thorn in my side of it, because I really like Saberwing and I still talk to the guy. He's doing very well at his new job. So, you know, follow him on Twitter, Shyhan, just go look for him and just follow him. He's a decent dude, really nice guy. So he's landed on his feet, as we would say, but it was kind of sucky that, you know, they downsized that team. That, you know, that kind of bothered me a bit. But to be honest, sometimes these things have to be done. I more than most understand you've got to be a bit, you know, kind of, you've got to cut to keep the company viable. And CCP at that time was probably not viable. I mean, I read annual reports. I'm a big nerd when it comes to annual reports, and I read CCPs every year. And, you know, it's pretty damning. It's not looking good. There's a really good video by Bam Havoc. Go check it out, where basically he talks about the annual statements, exactly as we've just discussed. And it isn't good, because a lot of money has been spent on Dust and Valkyrie to get them off the ground, so much so that their cash reserves are dwindling, which in theory, in a cash rich business, is not good. So, you know, I can only imagine that they've made these very, very challenging cutbacks to kind of rescue the game a bit, or the games rather. So I think, you know, without being negative, I think it was a tricky year this year. And I think particularly when you look at what good Saberwing did for the community, I do believe he did exceptionally good work for the community. He listened to people. You know, him and Frame have always done a great job being, you know, the kind of punch bags of the community. Now, Frame's obviously picked up that role. He's still doing it. You know, he's doing a great job. And he's doing it on his own now, I believe. So, you know, it's a tricky job to do. But I suspect it's made slightly easier by the announcement, because I think a lot of the alpha maleness and the chest beating, I think, reduced after the announcement, because people realised there's no point sticking your oar into Dust if there is no future for it. And I think a lot of the people who are, quote, power players decided that actually that's their cue to leave. But anyway, that's getting very topical. This was just amazing. People don't get that. I mean, that's the most amazing bit of scouting ever seen in the game ever. Because I jump off a drum onto a dropship, run along the hull of a dropship, jump down, plasma cannon a guy, then run away laughing into the distance. Come on, that's funny. And I think this is a great example of where, when you record, so if you see me in a match, 9 times out of 10 I'm recording. Not always, because sometimes I really don't. I don't always record, just because sometimes I can't be bothered. I really can't. But generally I'm recording. So this is why, because you'll pick up that odd moment, which is just exceptional. If you're doing something like this where you're bomb trucking, you know that you're going to have some good moments. You're going to record, but it's those odd matches where you're just running a regular match and something happens and something just goes odd. And we had a lot of kind of jittery, graphical problems. They were pretty fun. Just people, you know, jibbing out and falling off cranes or whatever. It's pretty cool. And I think that's the kind of thing that you would record for. I wish that the recording softwares were better for PlayStation. The Halpage box is great because it does produce a compressed video out. It's an MP4. If you want to get technical, it's an MP4, which when you then drop into what I use for editing, which is Premiere Pro, it's just bang straight in, and then you set it to HD, then you're off. Whereas on a PC, there's such better recording capability. Like, but I don't know if this is on the Halpage. I probably need to check this. Maybe I need to upgrade the software. But on PC, if you use things like Fraps, you can actually buffer your recording. So you can say, well, I'm not going to record all 20 hours of this. I'm just going to wait for something interesting to happen and then record it. And the way you do that is you use buffers, and then you just set the record. Something interesting happens, and as long as you then press the record button again within 60 minutes of it happening, so afterwards, it will then record from where 60 seconds was back before or more. And I think those kind of tools are brilliant. It's what these kind of things need. Recording console footage is a very long-winded process when you can't do that. So I think I might sit and work that out if we can actually do that. Otherwise, you just end up getting loads of footage. Anyway, look at me getting all YouTube-y on you. Sorry about that. The game by October, let's talk about that. This was when my plasma cannon was in. We celebrated our 617th Dust video because that's an important milestone in my mind. And I think just generally we were at this point enjoying the game significantly. But let me just share a little bit of insider knowledge with you. This is when 1.9 came out, but it's also when my job changed. So my IRL job, where I sit in a tie and a suit and I look like I'm knowledgeable and know what I'm doing, changed. And all of a sudden, I became super busy. Now, you know, I don't do these videos during the day, but I just started working into the night where it's just constantly going. We decided to do Series 4 of Kicking Dust as a much more produced video series. So you can see here, we've literally pulled together a much more graphical front end and then a commentary. The desire for this is that we couldn't do daily dusts anymore. We used to do dust every day because it was simple. You just had all the templates, you just cobbled it all together, and in a day I could do 7 videos in about 2 or 3 hours. Literally, that's all it was. Now, sadly, those days are gone because I'm working all the time, and I think this is sad. I would love, well, would I? Yeah, maybe would love to try being a full-time YouTuber, but to do that, you need to take partnerships, which we don't do. We don't do. We've rejected every single partnership that's come our way, and we have been offered pretty much all of them, except maybe the biggest. And that if that came along, we may take that. But I think at the moment, we're not doing it. You don't do it. You don't do YouTube for money. Let me be very clear on that. YouTube does not make money. It only makes money if you're in the top 1% or even 0.5% of YouTubers who actually has got, you know, a significant, it doesn't matter how many subs you've got, because you can have low subs but high views. And it really comes down to, unless you get millions and millions of views a week, you're not going to make much money from YouTube. And that's unfortunately the sad truth of it. You do not do this for the money. It's like becoming a musician. You don't become a musician to be, you know, rich. You become, or an artist, you know, this is art, this is video art. And the reason Trub and I did this channel is because we're very arty people in a hellish corporate blue chip environment where we have no ability to express our artistic flair. So this is why we produce videos, and this is why we do it. And we do it on gaming because we love gaming. So gaming, art, YouTube, wonderful connection of three. It's the triumvirate of content. And I always wanted to try and do stuff like this. I mean, I had this YouTube channel from 2006, but where I used to put videos on, but sadly I've lost most of my videos from way back. I don't know where they've gone. I have to check that. I think it's because they were copyrighted. I used music anyway. So long story short, we've gone to Kicking Dust 4 to be much more of a kind of bigger content produced show. Show, it sounds so wrong calling it a show, but so we just tried to do one of these a week. We could do more. Post in the comments if you would actually be interested in more. If you like the kind of funny kind of intro and wacky kind of highly produced video, or if you prefer me just gassing on about somebody I shot with a plasma cannon, you tell me. And you know, we react to exactly what you tell us. If you have games that you would like us to play, just tell us. We really do. We are completely community funded, community charged, whatever you call it, because we just listen to what the community says and we do it. You know, that is the beauty of YouTube. You can give us instant feedback, so tomorrow's video could be different, and that's wonderful. But I love doing little things like this. This little skit here was just, I was trying to kind of get upon this tower to stop the spawn campers or the tower campers. They shot me down. Isn't that beautiful, the little flare then shot? So simple to do, seriously. It's just, you know, put Premiere Pro and After Effects and all these things. This is what I use. I know some people use Sony Vegas. Sony Vegas is just for doing video splicing. You can't do any special effects with it. It's not designed for that. So I think it's a bit cheap. It's not my favorite. I didn't like it. Whereas Premiere Pro was like sitting at a nuclear control panel with hundreds of buttons and knobs and things. And it looked daunting and it was horrendous to learn. But now I've learned it, I feel I can do most things with this game. You know, so if I wanted to do anything in After Effects, I'm pretty good at that now. And I think that's kind of the beauty of these things, is that, you know, you should add value to what you do. It's not just about filming the game and then talking over it, which unfortunately is a lot about nowadays. There should be something else, like, you know, putting humorous things on the screen or just telling a story, and that's really what it's about. Look at that. I know that looks terrible now. I look back at it, I'm embarrassed about that, but look, we put Christmas lights around the thing. People miss that. It took me ages to put those Christmas lights around the screen, and then the Christmas tree, I got it wrong. I put a layer in when I shouldn't have, and so it looks obviously pasted in, but there we go. But yeah, I highly recommend, if you love YouTube, if you watch YouTube, then you should just enjoy what you do. So you tell us what you like and we'll obviously react to that. We love Dust and we're never going to walk away from Dust. It is such a good game. It's such a fun game. And I think for me, we'll keep playing it until they switch the servers off. But there is a caveat with this, in that it is getting harder and harder to play. The Unholy Legion is dead. Our corp is absolutely dead. So we maybe need to start a new corp. I don't know. Maybe, you know, when PC changes next year, maybe I actually don't want to run a corp anymore. Not that I ever did, really, but it'd be nice to maybe join a gang of veterans. So maybe post in the comments if you're a gang of veterans and you want a video. I don't know. These are all things I'm kind of mulling over in my mind. So post in the comments, let me know what you think. And I think, for me, we're sticking with Dust. It is a great game. We love it. And I think, really, it comes down to, you know, as long as CCP produce or provide the game, we'll keep playing it. And that's really all there is to say about that. So there we go. That was a director's commentary. I've always wanted to do one of these. I'm sure it was an absolute load of bilge, but at least at the end of the day, I got two videos out of one, so I can't complain about that. Hope you enjoyed that. See you next time, brah.